What's good, YouTube? It's your boy SeriousMindsTV back in here with another video. And yes, you guys, the 2017 NBA playoffs are upon us. The NBA playoffs tip off this Saturday. Now, this year, this season, it was a decent season. I mean, I can't complain about it, you know. It doesn't hold a light to last season. But I digress. This season did see a lot of historical feats be accomplished, with the main one being Russell Westbrook becoming the first player since Oscar Robertson to average a triple-double in a season. So, yeah, man, the playoffs are finally upon us, man. I can't wait to see, you know, all the stuff that's going on. It's a bunch of storylines heading into this year's postseason. Now, before I get into my predictions, I would have to say, as far as the first round is concerned, I don't see many sweeps. I see one sweep, but that's it. I see a lot of 5-6, maybe even like a couple 7-game series or whatever. But just want to throw that out there before I get into my prediction video. But anyway, with that being said, in this video, I am going to be giving my thoughts and opinions on who will be winning the 2017 NBA Finals. So with that being said, let's go ahead and hop into the first round of the Western Conference. First off, we have the 1-8 matchup featuring the Golden State Warriors versus the Portland Trail Blazers. Now, we have a point guard matchup in this series. We have Damian Lillard going up against Stephen Curry. Now, during the regular season, the Warriors swept the Blazers during the regular season. You know, the only game that was close was that last game, which the Warriors won 113-111. Now, Damian Lillard gets to play in his hometown, you know what I'm saying, for a few games. He gets to play against his hometown team in the playoffs, which I'm pretty sure is you know, a big thing for him. Now, in this series, I do have the Warriors. I say it's going to be a sweep, but don't be surprised if this series goes 5. But most likely, I feel like the Warriors won't have any trouble with the Blazers. I really don't think that it's going to be too much of a hassle for the Warriors to get past the Blazers, because I feel like this series is like they're going to use it to get Kevin Durant more acclimated back in, because Ronji, he was out for 17 games, I believe. So they're just taking this time just to get him acclimated back into the offense, and maybe he can rest a little bit more. But yeah, I do have the Golden State Warriors moving past the Portland Trail Blazers in a sweep for that series. Moving on, we have the 2-7 matchup. We have the San Antonio Spurs versus the Memphis Grizzlies. Now, these two teams have had playoff battles before. Their first one being in 2011, which the Memphis Grizzlies upset the San Antonio Spurs. Then in 2013, they met again in the Western Conference Finals, in which the Spurs beat Memphis. I think this series is going to go 5. You know, because I really don't see the Memphis Grizzlies putting up a fight. News just came out today that Tony Allen will be out indefinitely with, I think, a leg injury. So that's their biggest defender, you know what I'm saying? So that's a big, you know, hurt for the Grizzlies. The Grizzlies are an older team. You know, they have a lot of veterans on that team. So they have some young players, but they rely mainly on that inside game, with that grit and grind with Mark Gasol and Zach Randolph. And this is a matchup between brothers, between Powell and Mark. But I honestly, you know, see the Spurs moving past the Grizzlies in 5 games. So I don't doubt that the Spurs will have any trouble with Memphis. Moving on to the 3-6 matchup. In my opinion, this is the best matchup, the best first round playoff series that I've seen in a long time. We have the Houston Rockets versus the Oklahoma City Thunder, a matchup between two MVP candidates. We have Russell Westbrook going up against James Harden. A lot of people saying that these two guys are going to be COVID MVPs, if not one or the other. Man, this is going to be a really exciting series. I can't wait to see who comes out on top of that series. I honestly think this is going to go 7 games. This has the opportunity to go 7 games, because looking at the teams around them, you got Russell Westbrook, who is basically Mr. Triple-Double. James Harden can drop a triple-double too. So these two guys are going to be going at it strong. So I can't wait to see what goes on during this series. I think the biggest factor in this series is bench play and support. I think that Houston has the best support because James Harden has a lot of scores around him. Westbrook has to do a lot of work on his own. Don't get it twisted. The Thunder are still a good team. I mean, it's surprising that they made the playoffs this year after the departure of Kevin Durant. But I think that's going to be the biggest, that's going to be the X factor is bench play and support. But honestly, I want to say in my heart wants to say the Thunder will win in seven. But I'm going to go with my basketball decision and the smart one. And I'm going to say Houston will win this series in seven. You know what I'm saying? I think Houston will move on in seven games. I think that Harden has more help down the stretch because he can give it to, you know, he can give it to a lot of different people and they can facilitate off of him. So I got Houston winning that series. In the final first round matchup, we have a 4-5 matchup pitting the Los Angeles Clippers against the Utah Jazz. 4-5 matchups are always the most tightly contested matchups because most of the time, these two teams are equal. They usually have the same record. And this series kind of reminds me of those old 4-5 matchups in the West during the 90s when you saw Utah playing a lot. You saw Houston playing in those kind of series, like those kind of tough series, you know what I'm saying? And I'm glad to see Utah back in the playoffs. This is the first time they've been back in the playoffs, I think, since 2010, 2011, or something like that in that area. But it's glad to see, you know, Utah back in the playoffs because they could have been in it last year, but they lost the last night of the season. And they won 50-plus games, so it's a great job for the guys in Utah. But I feel like this series is a must-win for Los Angeles, and it's because I feel like if they don't win this series, hell, if they don't even win the whole championship, that team is going to get broken up because they have had chance after chance after chance to win in the playoffs, and they still haven't done it yet. So I feel like this series is going to be tightly contested, but I do give the slight edge to the Clippers. I feel like the Clippers have more star power, and they can get scoring from their starting group and their bench. I feel like that's going to overpower Utah. Now, don't get it twisted. I see this series going six games. I think the wins will rotate, but I think that the Clippers will eventually gain an upper hand, and I think the Clippers will win this game in the series in six, mainly due because the Clippers feel like they have to win this series. They just have to. So I got the Clippers winning in six games. So let's go ahead and switch to the Eastern Conference first-round matchups. Starting off with that 1-8 matchup, we have the Boston Celtics versus the Chicago Bulls. Now, in this series, you know what I'm saying, Chicago, they had a tough time, you know, trying to get to the playoffs. They finally did, you know, because they held off. They won on the last night of the season. But this series right here, I feel like nobody should take Chicago for granted. I feel like nobody should take Chicago for granted because they have Dwayne Wade, Rondo playing, and Butler playing. But I think the key in this series is who is going to come up clutch in the fourth quarter. That's going to be the main question. I feel like Boston has that upper edge with Isaiah Thomas. He is Mr. Fourth Quarter. And I feel like if the games are close, they are going to get the ball in his hands. And I can really see Isaiah Thomas dominating this series. I see him dropping a couple of 40-point games in this series. I really do. I really see Isaiah Thomas going off in this series. So with that being said, I have the Celtics winning this series in six. I would say five, but I'm not going to short play the Bulls like that because I know that they're going to get some wins at home. So I'm going to say the Celtics will win this series in six. And if so, for the Bulls, Coach Fred Hoiberg, he has to be fired if the Bulls lose this series. But I feel like they will. So I got the Celtics beating the Bulls in six. Then we have that 2-7 matchup. We have the Cleveland Cavaliers versus the Indiana Pacers. Now, a lot of people were, you know, up in arms about, you know, Cleveland not getting number one seed in the Eastern Conference. Boston has that. But it's nothing to worry about because LeBron James has gone to the NBA Finals 5 times as a 2 seed. Now, as a 2 seed. So, you know, and he's won championships as a number 2 seed, both in 2012 and 2000. And yeah, in 2012, he won in 2012 as a 2 seed. You know what I'm saying? But this series right here, this is going to be a great one because I love the matchup between Paul George and LeBron James. I love that matchup. It seems that LeBron brings the best out of Paul George. And I love seeing those two guys going at it because if you remember, when the Heat and Pacers was going back and forth in the Eastern Conference Finals back in 2013-2014, especially in 2013, that's when we saw Paul George become the Paul George we all know now because his play was elevated in the Eastern Conference Finals against the Heat. Now, I think this series, it has the potential to go 7, especially if it has those kind of games. Like, because they played, like, last week, and they had a game that went double overtime, I believe it was. Either a week ago or 2 weeks ago. But they had a game that went double overtime. If they have games like that, I would not be surprised if this series goes 7. But I do got LeBron and Cleveland winning this series in 6 games. I think with all that doubt going on in Cleveland, I think that LeBron and Kyrie, they are going to shut up their doubters and be like, okay, we run the Eastern Conference, and we want to show you why we run the Eastern Conference. We may not have number 2 seed, but we're going to show you why we run the Eastern Conference. So I do see the Cavaliers moving on and beating the Pacers in about 6 games. Now moving on to that 3-6 matchup. We have the Toronto Raptors versus the Milwaukee Bucks. Now, this matchup right here is hard to pinpoint. And the main reason why it's hard to pinpoint is because, you know, it could go either way, to be honest with you, to be really honest with you. But if I had to give an upper hand, I would say that the series can go to Toronto. And I hope this series is not boring. I hope it's not boring. I really hope that this series is not a drain. I really hope not because, you know, I love seeing DeMar DeRozan and Kyle Lowry play. But I also love seeing the Greek Freak play. The problem is going to be is who else can step in for Milwaukee. That's going to be the main question. Because with the Raptors, they have experience. And they have star power on their side. They have scoring. So that's the big thing. You know, Toronto has that. But what does Milwaukee have? All they have is the Greek Freak. Who else can help? So with that being said, I got Toronto beating the Milwaukee Bucks in about six games. Moving on to the final first round matchup in the Eastern Conference, we have that 4-5 matchup between the Washington Wizards and the Atlanta Hawks. This is another matchup that can go either way. It really can because both teams are equally matched as far as star players and wherever they can get scoring from. But I think Washington is going to win this series. I feel like Washington is going to win this series because I think backcourt play is going to be key in this matchup. I think Beal and Wall are going to dominate that series. Like, they're capable of getting 30 apiece if they wanted to. They really capable of it. But I feel like that backcourt is going to dominate that series. And I see Washington, this season will be close, but I see Washington winning this series. In about 6 games to move on to the second round. So with that being said, let's go ahead and switch gears to the conference semifinals. Starting in the West, we have a 1-4 matchup. We have the Golden State Warriors versus the Los Angeles Clippers. Now, many people have wanted to see this as a playoff series ever since 2015. We saw this in 2014 because remember when that whole Donald Sterling thing happened, blah, blah, blah. But the games wasn't as hyped as we've seen. These two teams, when they go at it, they go at it. Like, and I've been waiting to see a playoff series between these two teams. And, you know, look at the star power that is on display. You got Steph, you got Klay, you got KD, you got Chris Paul, you got DeAndre Jordan, Blake Griffin, all this star power in a playoff series. And I can't wait to see that because I know it's going to happen. Now, I think this is where the Clippers, I think this is where they have trouble. This is where their trouble starts to kick in. I think in this series, I think Kevin Durant and Steph, their star power is going to shine through this series. Like, I see KD and Steph having maybe like one 40-point game, maybe two. But I do see them scoring a lot in this series. Because I think this is going to be the series where it puts the league on notice. Like, damn, these guys are going to get it in the playoffs where the play is intensified. We're going to show the league and we're going to show the world why the Warriors are one of the dangerous teams in the NBA. So I see the Warriors winning that series. I'm going to say five. I'm going to say they win that series in five games. Five. It could be a sweep. But I say they win that series in about five games. So I got Golden State moving on to the Western Conference Finals. For the last conference semifinals matchup in the West, we have the San Antonio Spurs going up against the Houston Rockets. This is a Texas showdown. We got Houston, we got San Antonio. Now, back in the day, these two teams used to go at it in the playoffs, especially in that 1995 Western Conference Finals series. I feel like in this matchup, I think San Antonio has the upper hand. I think coaching is going to be the biggest emphasis in this matchup. Let me tell you why. I feel like Mike D'Antoni, he wants to outscore you. But Coach Pop wants to beat you mentally on the defensive end. I think system is going to be a big part in this game. I know Houston loves to run a gun. But once San Antonio gets that half-court offense and they set it up, especially with Kawhi, watch out for Kawhi Leonard in this series, because I don't think they have Trevor Ariza, but I think Kawhi is better than him. So I see the Spurs mentally challenging the Rockets. So I think San Antonio beats Houston in about five games, honestly. So I got Houston losing to San Antonio in six. So I got Golden State and San Antonio moving on to the Western Conference Finals. Sorry for the change in scenery, man. I had to move the location of production because, you know, had company or whatever. But as I was saying before, the first semifinal matchup in the Eastern Conference, we have a 1-4 matchup between the Boston Celtics and the Washington Wizards. Now, these two teams have formed a great rivalry in the NBA this season. If you guys remember how Jay Crowder and John Wall got into it? Remember how that one game, the whole Washington Wizards team came dressed in black? And those games were very good games, might I add. So, I want to see how this series is going to play out. Now, I would not be surprised if this series goes 7. I really would not be surprised. If it does, that will make for great television. You know what I'm saying? To see a great rivalry go 7 games. I can't wait to see that. But in my opinion, I feel like Boston has the slight edge in this series. A slight edge. Not a big one, but a slight one. The key for Boston in this series is they need to start off strong and stay consistent. Don't wait until the fourth quarter to come around to plan a comeback. So you have to put all that pressure on Isaiah Thomas. Don't do that. Just start off strong from the get-go. Utilize all your parts. And then in the fourth quarter, if y'all are up or at least tied, let Isaiah Thomas be Mr. Fourth Quarter. If y'all don't do that, Bradley Beal and John Wall and the rest of the Wizards team, they eat y'all alive, so y'all got to come with it. But I do give Boston an upper hand, and I do have Boston win this series in about 6 or 7 games. Now, with the final matchup in the conference semifinals in the East, we have a 2-3 matchup. We have the Cleveland Cavaliers going up against the Toronto Raptors. This is a rematch of last year's Eastern Conference Finals. Now, this year, DeMar DeRozan has played at another level. Like, I call him the new Kobe Bryant because he can make anything happen. You know what I'm saying? Anything happen from the mid-range, you know what I'm saying? And I love how consistent he is as a scorer. They playing great basketball at the right time. Kyle Lowry came at just in time. They got Serge Ibaka now, so that's an extra big. So this series should be better than last year's conference finals. But I feel like LeBron in this series, this is where they're going to show that championship pedigree. I feel like this series, they're going to be like, okay, well, everybody talk mess about us. We're going to show them why we run the East. We're going to show them why we the defending champions. So I feel like LeBron and Kyrie are going to have big series against the Raptors. And I do see Cleveland beating the Raptors in six games. I think that eventually the Raptors, they're going to do good at some points, but I feel like, you know what I'm saying, especially I don't think Toronto, they may get a game in Cleveland, but I feel like their wins are going to come in games 3 and 4, just like last postseason. So that's how I feel about that. So I have Cleveland moving on to the Eastern Conference Finals, beating the Raptors in six games. Now we head into the Conference Finals. In the West, we have a 1-2 matchup pitting the Golden State Warriors versus the San Antonio Spurs. Everybody wanted to see this matchup in the Conference Finals last season, but we didn't get to see it because the Thunder knocked out the Spurs in the Conference Semifinals. This series should be a barn burner. This series should go the distance. This series should go seven games. I feel like, you know, during the season, their games really was competitive because, like, the first game of the season they had was a blowout. Then they had that big primetime game, but everybody sat out. Then the third and final game they had, it was cool, but it became a blowout towards the third and fourth quarter. So in this series, I feel like Curry is going to make quite an impact in this series because if you guys remember back in 2013, they played the Spurs, I think the second round of the playoffs, and they didn't really do so good. Like, that's when we saw Curry being Curry, you know what I'm saying? But they lost to the Spurs. I forgot how many games. But I feel like Curry is going to make his impact in this series because he wants to be shown as the best. And going up against the Spurs, you have to bring your A game. So this series does have the potential to go seven games. If it does go seven games, I got the Warriors in either six or seven. In about six or seven games. Now, moving on to the Eastern Conference Finals, we have a 1-2 matchup. We have the Boston Celtics going up against the Cleveland Cavaliers. Now, the big storyline going on in this series is, did the number one seed really matter? That's going to be the biggest storyline going on in this series because for the latter part of the season, it was between Boston and Cleveland on who would get the number one seed. And like I said before, LeBron has got to the finals as number two seed 5 times. He won the finals as a two seed back in 2012. And if you remember in the conference finals in 2015, he was a two seed and they swept Atlanta, who had the better record. So, but I think this series, it's going to be back and forth, but I think in this series right here, I think that inexperience will show because I'm pretty sure a lot of the players on the Celtics squad, that's going to be the first time going to the conference finals. So I think they are going to suffer from the same mishaps that Toronto suffered through last season. Just inexperience. A lot of these players are young, haven't had much playoff experience, haven't made it past the first round. Now they're in the conference finals, so I think that little inexperienced mistakes will happen. I think Cleveland will attack those inexperiences. And I feel like Cleveland is going to win this one in six. I think Cleveland's going to win this one in six because, honestly, I think Boston is going to be... Boston has the best chance to beat Cleveland. I think either Toronto or Boston has the best chance to beat Cleveland. Maybe even Washington has the best chance to beat Cleveland. But I feel like Cleveland, they run the East. And I feel like Cleveland, they want to get to the finals to repeat, and that's what they're going to do. Moving on to the NBA Finals, we have a rematch. We have the Golden State Warriors going up against the Cleveland Cavaliers. If this matchup does happen, it will be the first time in NBA history that two teams have faced each other in the finals for 3 straight years. The whole world wants to see this. It's full of superstars, full of storylines. The main storyline is going to be, can the Warriors redeem themselves after letting go of that 3-1 lead last year And will Kevin Durant win his first NBA championship? Well, I think in this series, I think if all teams are healthy, this is going to be a good series. But I think Kevin Durant, he wants to redeem himself because it will be his first time being in the finals after 5 years. And he was 24 at the time. Now he's, what, 28, 29. So he can redeem himself. He's a much mature player. And he's tired of being number two. He wants to be the best player. So I think he's going to take that race down to LeBron. And he wants to show, like, hey, I deserve to be a world champion. I came here to Golden State to win. And I feel like the Warriors are going to do that. I feel like, personally, the Warriors will beat the Cavaliers in six on Cleveland's home floor, just like they did 2 years ago. You know what I'm saying? I think Durant will have a good series. I think Curry will have a good series. I'm waiting on either Curry or Durant, maybe Thompson, to have like a big, big scoring finals game. I'm waiting on that. I haven't seen it yet. I want to see it. You know what I'm saying? I want to see something that I want to talk about. But in my opinion, I feel like the Golden State Warriors will beat the Cleveland Cavaliers in six games to win their second championship in 3 years. But yeah, man, those were just my thoughts and my opinions and my predictions on the 2017 NBA playoffs. If you enjoyed this video, please do me a big favor and hit that like button for your boy. Also, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Let me know what you guys thought about this video down in the comment section below. Like I said, be sure to hit that like button, follow me on social media, all that good stuff. Who do you think will win the 2017 NBA championship? Leave all your predictions down in the comment section below. Also, be sure to follow me on social media, my links in the description box below, and all that good stuff. So, it's your boy, SeriousMindsTV, and I'm out.